The report also shed light on bottlenecks in the system which impede socioeconomic growth. This include the unattractive investment climate, ineffective performance management systems, skills deficit, and illicit financial flows running into billions of dollars required to stimulate economic growth, to fight poverty and youth unemployment. Speaking at the launch, Director General of the National Planning Commission, Obeth Kanjole, indicated that the COVID-19 pandemic and global recession have been persistent threats on the positive gains attained since independence. The reclassification of Namibia in 2009 by the World Bank as an upper-middle-income country also added a burden on the ability to access foreign loans for developmental purposes at favorable rates. As such, Kanjole says the country must explore new ways to mobilize money from a variety of sources, both domestically and internationally, to meet its developmental agenda.
The levels of poverty using the multidimensional poverty index, as revealed in the report cited earlier, is stunningly above 40% of Namibian population. The current economic headwinds experience the high levels of unemployment in the country, the outbreak of COVID-19 pandemic, and collapse of private sector investment threatens to reverse the achievements of the three decades and dampens the hope to achieve the promise of Vision 2030 and sustainable development goals. Namibia thus cannot afford to spare all efforts in breaking the emerging trend. There is necessity, therefore, to devise coherent policies and strategies, including the integrated financial framework, to reinvigorate and sustain economic growth, social cohesion, and environmental protection for current and future generations.
The report also criticized the weak implementation of the performance management system, saying there are no penalties or rewards to ensure results-based accountability of public officials.
As the country experiences a substantial decrease in FDI, mainly due to the completion of major mining outlays, near collapse of the commodity prices, and persistent drought to some extent. The report affirms that despite the fact that Namibia is an upper middle income country, the country can still leverage offshore development assistance as a catalyst for other forms of development finance.
A few stakeholders including the United Nations, Germany's developmental agency GIZ, and the Ministry of Finance pledged support towards the outcome of the report. Kaipa Herwekanji, NBC News, Windhoek.